This is ANN News Brief.
Burkina Faso military says the number of soldiers killed in a suspected jihadist attack on Monday has risen to 24. Dozens of militants are reported to have stormed the army base in northern Soum province, arriving on motorbikes and pickup trucks. This is believed to be the heaviest loss the army has suffered in its campaign against Islamic militias. The army had earlier put the death toll at 10 and said it had launched a land and air operation in response to the attack in Koutougou, in northern Burkina Faso Soum province. It added in a statement on Tuesday, 7 other soldiers were wounded and 5 are still missing. Burkina Faso's main opposition party, the Union for Progress and Change, has called on the government to resign, accusing it of failing to contain the jihadists who have killed hundreds of people in recent years. Jihadist threat has killed hundreds of civilians and caused more than 150,000 to flee. Deteriorating security prompted the Ouagadougou government to declare a state of emergency in December in several northern provinces bordering Mali, including Soum. South Africa President Cyril Ramaphosa is facing the most embarrassing period of his presidency. Leaked bank statements revealed names of donors as well as people who allegedly received money from Ramaphosa's CR17 fundraising campaign, set up to help him become African National Congress leader 2 years ago. Two opposition MPs from the Economic Freedom Fighters, whose names appeared in the bank statements widely shared on social media, resigned after admitting to receiving funds from the CR17 campaign. Tabogo Mokwela stated in her resignation letter that she received two payments of 40,000 rand, that is $2,600 each, for personal use. Another MP, Kwasigand Mogosi, said she had collected the same amount. A decision, Mogosi says, was related to personal situations she had. President Ramaphosa's office has responded for the first time since the leaks at the weekend. His spokesperson, Kusela Diko, says it simply shows that the president is a caring and compassionate human being. The president, who campaigned on a ticket of clean government, is expected to face opposition MPs in parliament this week in a question and answer session. Those MPs are already rubbing their hands together in anticipation. We'll be back after this message.
Whether in your house, at your office, on your phone or online, we are there. We have the facts behind the headlines. We cut to the chase with the news you really need. We cover every angle. We are the bigger, better news network. We are African News Network, ANN. Watch ANN News on MITV from a truly African spirit.
Still in South Africa, where three lions killed a man at a game reserve in South Africa's capital, Pretoria. An emergency services spokesman, Zandile Lupse, says the victim was the owner of lions on the farm in the game reserve. Staff members shot and killed the animals after the attack, and that decision was to gain access to recover the corpse. That is ANN News Brief. For details on these and other breaking stories, visit our website, annafrica.news. Conversation continues on our social media platforms, Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook at ANN Africa TV. I am Olajumoke Olatunji.